Have you ever wondered what are the best fruits that you can eat if you have a thyroid disorder? Hi, I am Dr. Anshul Gupta. I am a functional medicine and integrative medicine expert, and I help people reverse their thyroid disease. So one of the most common questions that I get asked is that, what are the best fruits that I can eat if I have a thyroid disease? So that's what we are going to talk about today. The best fruits, the five best fruits that you can eat with thyroid disease. So let's get started. So the first fruit we are going to talk about is blueberries. Yes, blueberries are the best fruits that you can eat for your thyroid disease. In fact, I call them superfoods. Why is that so? So blueberries are low glycemic index food. What that means is that when you eat blueberries, they do not raise your sugar up. And the sugar is very, very inflammatory to your body. So the low glycemic index foods helps to reduce sugar, and that's way helps to reduce inflammation. So blueberries are low glycemic index foods. The second advantage of blueberries, they are high in vitamins and minerals like vitamin C, vitamin K, and manganese. And they are all needed to support your thyroid gland. But the biggest advantage of blueberries is in their color. The purple color of blueberries is because of a compound called flavonoids. Now these flavonoids have so many important functions in your body, but the most important function is that they act as an antioxidant. So what are antioxidants? So antioxidants are compounds which help to reduce inflammation in your body, and they help to lower the inflammation. And we know that in thyroid disease patients, inflammation is the main reason what is causing the destruction of the thyroid gland. These flavonoids help to reduce inflammation and safeguards your thyroid gland. And thus, they help your thyroid gland a lot. So as you see, blueberries are wonderful foods. You know, they are packed with certain vitamins and minerals. They are low glycemic index. And plus, they have flavonoids as the compounds in them, which acts as antioxidants and helps save your thyroid gland. The second fruit that you should eat on the regular basis is strawberries. Yes, everybody loves strawberries, and they are good for your thyroid gland too. Why are strawberries good? So again, strawberries have relatively less amount of sugar in them. So that way, again, they reduces inflammation in your body. The second advantage of strawberries are they are packed with vitamins and minerals, especially vitamin C. Yes, strawberries are high in vitamin C. One serving of strawberries actually contains 51 milligrams of vitamin C. So that is very, very nice. You know, vitamin C helps with your immune function as well as helps to safeguard your thyroid gland and improves thyroid function. But again, the main advantage of strawberries is in color. The main advantage of strawberries is it's in color. Okay, so the strawberries are filled with phytonutrients, okay? And these phytonutrients, again, acts as an antioxidant and also helps with detoxification of your body. So strawberries with their phytonutrients helps to reduce the toxin burden in your body, helps with detox, and also helps with reducing inflammation. So as you see, strawberries are also wonderful foods. They are not only less in sugars, but they are also high source of vitamin C, and also have phytonutrients, which acts as antioxidants and also helps with detoxification of your body. So that's why strawberries are good fruits to eat if you have thyroid disease. The third fruit that you can eat on the regular basis is apples. Yes, you might have heard one apple a day keeps the doctor away. So that's true. The apples are very, very nutritious food for your thyroid gland. So why is the case? So again, apples are filled with certain vitamins and minerals which supports your thyroid gland. But apples again, you know, have certain phytonutrients, especially a phytonutrient called quercetin. The quercetin has so many different benefits for your body. It helps with reducing allergies. It helps with mast cell disorder. It helps with reducing inflammation. And it also helps with reducing pain in your body. So that's the reason that quercetin is very, very useful, and the apple skin is very, very high in quercetin. So if you're eating apples, make sure that you eat the apple skin along with it. The other advantage of apples is that It has good amount of fiber in it, especially soluble fiber called pectin. Now this soluble fiber actually acts as a prebiotic for your good bacteria in your gut and promotes the growth of the good bacteria. And now we know that the gut health is directly related to your thyroid health. So if you promote good bacteria and good gut health, then it helps with your thyroid functioning. It helps with reducing inflammation, which again safeguards your thyroid gland. So as you see, apple is also a wonderful fruit which you can add to help with your thyroid gland. The fourth food that is wonderful for your thyroid gland is pomegranate. Now you might not have heard of pomegranate because it's not very popular fruit, but it has so many health benefits. So if you look at the pomegranate juice, again it has a very, very different color, and the reason of that color is polyphenols. So these polyphenols have very, very high amount of antioxidants. Now you might have heard polyphenols are also present in red wine as well as green tea, and that gives them the health benefits. But do you know that? The one serving of pomegranate juice has more polyphenols than wine or green tea. So that's the reason pomegranate is very, very nice for your thyroid gland. So these polyphenols, which are high in antioxidants, helps to reduce inflammation in your thyroid gland, actually helps to lower the cholesterol down, and also improves with pain. So if you have any kind of pain, or if you feel that your cholesterol is high, then pomegranate can be very, very helpful for your thyroid gland. Okay? The fifth fruit that you should include if you have a thyroid disease is avocados. Yes, so avocados sometimes are called as fruits, sometimes they are included in vegetables, but truly actually they are fruits. So why avocados? So avocados have so many health benefits. So avocados are high in good fats, especially monounsaturated fats. So what these fats do is actually reduce the amount of cholesterol that you have, especially the bad cholesterol. So these good fats gives you good energy for your body and also helps to reduce your cholesterol. Now avocados are also high in vitamins and minerals like vitamin C, vitamin K and potassium. Do you know that? Avocados have more potassium than bananas, right? That's surprising. The other benefit of avocados is that they are high in fibers, okay? So again, you know, they have both soluble and insoluble fibers. And again, fiber helps out with your gut health. So they act as prebiotics as well as they act as insoluble fibers, which keeps your gut inflammation down. And as I already told you, when your gut inflammation is down, when your gut is healthy, then your thyroid gland also works better. So that's the reason avocados have all these good benefits. They have good fats, which reduce your cholesterol. They have high potassium, which again helps your thyroid gland. And they are high in fiber, which again helps with your gut health, which indirectly helps your thyroid gland. So that's the way all these five fruits are must have if you have a thyroid disorder. So again, these five fruits are: first, blueberries; second, strawberries; third, apples; fourth, pomegranate; fifth, avocados. Okay, if you have any questions, reach out to me. But I have also written a blog post about these fruits, and I'm going to link the blog post in the description. And also, if you have a thyroid disorder and you want to improve it, or you want to reverse your thyroid disease, then you can work with me through a virtual consultation.